Hi, in this video we're going to explore the software and hardware of Dash. So let's have a look at the features that we can see. Dash has programmable LEDs that you can see on the eyes and ears. There are also programmable buttons on the top of the head. These are used to customise the Dash experience. Proximity sensors are found in between the front legs, left and right, and one on the back leg. These sensors detect objects. Dash comes with two sturdy wheels to navigate and track on almost any surface. The white on-off button is found here. To turn it on, press the button once and the button will illuminate and Dash will become animated. When you've finished, to turn Dash off, you also press the button once and the lights will go off. To charge Dash, the kit comes with a 10-port USB charger. The bright orange cables have two ends. The USB connects into the charging station, and on the side you'll find the on-off switch and also where the power cord goes. You can charge up to 10 devices at once. Dash has other features that we can't see. It has motors so the head can pan and tilt, receivers and transmitters that allow communication with other robots, microphones and speakers to triangulate a voice or sound, personalise recordings and provide playback. Dash also has three sensors, an accelerometer that measures the vibration or acceleration of motion, a gyroscope to measure or maintain orientation and angular velocity, and wheel encoders that measure rotational speed of motors and wheels. Dash has Bluebot connectivity to communicate and program with Dash using devices such as laptops, iPads, tablets, and phones. To use, place Dash on the floor to prevent damage from falling off furniture. The tablet robotic kit contains extra accessories for Dash. These are the brick connectors. They're compatible with Lego bricks, Lego kits, and Lego techniques. They can extend the learning experience by incorporating design thinking and problem solving. So we can see the connectors can be added at different parts of Dash, on the head or the legs. On the examples we have here, the bricks have been attached to the connectors to characterise Dash, and on the one at the front here, we've got bricks that have been attached to the connectors to act as a scoop and collect things when moving. Here are some extra examples of these building brick connectors being used. You can see Dash holding a pen to draw. You can build individualised accessories to collect, pull or push objects, and the connectors can be used to personalise or create characters, which is great if you're using Dash to tell stories. To program Dash, there are a number of software options. The apps you can see here are for various age groups and abilities, which means Dash can be used across stages. These apps are Connect software, and they don't collect any personal information about children under the age of 13 without parent consent. The iPad apps that we'll be looking at include Path, Wonder, Blockly, and Swift Playgrounds. Path is a great app for K-2 students. It assists in developing their understanding of digital systems, how devices communicate, as well as develop and follow a series of simple steps. Path also provides the opportunity for students to focus on fine motor iPad skills such as tap, zoom, and pan. Wonder is a great app for students in years 3 to 6. It helps to develop their understanding of digital systems, how they represent and transmit data, as well as use visual programming to follow algorithms and develop solutions. So Wonder has over 50 challenges and a remote control. Blockly is also a great app for students from years 3 to 6. It introduces fundamental and advanced coding concepts through projects, puzzles, and an open platform. Swift Playgrounds is great for students from years 5 through to 8. It starts with fundamentals of intuitive text-based coding. So all of these apps provide a great progression through the curriculum. There is also a browser-based software that teachers can use in a classroom setting. The browser-based software can be found at code.makewonder.com/landing. And this is a great solution if the iPads from the tablet robotics kit are also being used by another class. There's also a teacher application called Class Connect, and in the app, you might notice a pop-up referring to Class Connect. This is a paid application, but it does allow for you to collect all the student information and programs in the one place. Thanks for joining in, and be sure to check out the videos on how to use the iPad apps, Path, Wonder, Blockly, and Swift Playgrounds.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEM T4L Facebook community? It's a closed group. You can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.